cual se estará disputando entre China, Taipei y los Estados Unidos por el primer y segundo puesto de esta categoría junior masculina. Acá en el pabellón África del Parque Olímpico de la Ciudad Autónoma de Buenos Aires, en esta competencia que es el hockey en línea. A continuación, la formación de China Taipei.
Now please hear the lineup of the team of Chinese Taipei.
Con el número 69.
Number 69.
Chung Hsien Chen. Con el número 65.
Number 65.
Chen Yu Chu. Con el número 32.
Number 32.
Song Che Ho. Con el número 16.
Number 16.
Po Sun Xiu. Con el número 17.
Number 17.
Wei Hong Su. Con el número 18.
Number 18.
Chen Yu Huo. Con el número 14.
Number 14.
Bin Ru Lai. Con el número 6.
Number 6.
Chi Han Li. Con el número 71.
Number 71.
Wei Kai Sun. Con el número 66.
Number 66.
Ji He Sai. Con el número 97, el capitán del equipo.
And number 97.
Yan Chen Su. Con el número 29.
Number 29.
Wu Wei Wu. Con el número 3.
Number 3.
Hu Chen Zhang. Entrenador del equipo.
And the coach of Team Chinese Taipei is
Chun Lai Liu. Por el lado de los Estados Unidos, la formación es la siguiente.
The lineup of the team of the United States of America is composed of.
Con el número 3.
Number 3.
Aidan Boy. Con el número 9.
Number 9.
Matthew Fisher. Con el número 19.
Number 19.
Michael Jagello. Con el número 95.
Number 95.
Jack Lyon. Con el número 21.
Number 21.
Jordan Nau Barrigar. Con el número 87.
Number 87.
Sammy Phillips. Con el número 4, el capitán del equipo.
Number 4.
Christian Retro Mónaco. Con el número 70.
Number 70.
Andrew Segel. Con el número 88.
Number 88.
Kenneth Sealan. Con el número 66.
Number 66.
Austin Soboslai. Con el número 15.
Number 15.
Jesse Strasbourg. Con el número 65.
Number 65.
Cole Taylor. Con el número 10.
Number 10.
Adrian Wisniewski. Con el número 22.
Number 22.
Carson Woodcourt. Entrenador y coach del equipo.
And the coach of Team USA is
Daniel Maxwell. De esa manera quedaron presentados los dos equipos que estarán disputándose en instantes, en tan solo 50 segundos, por la medalla de oro y por la medalla de plata. Por el lado de China Taipei con camiseta blanca y vivos azules. Y por el lado de los Estados Unidos con camiseta azul y vivos blancos. Ya está todo listo, todo preparado para que en instantes el disco comience a deslizarse en esta pista. En este World Skate Games Argentina 2022, categoría junior masculina. Que en instantes estaremos disfrutando, viviendo un show espectacular de estas dos selecciones que dieron todo en estos 7 días de intenso torneo de lo que es el hockey en línea. Y lo estás viviendo en el pabellón África del Parque Olímpico de la Ciudad Autónoma de Buenos Aires. Árbitro del encuentro, Johan Friver de Suecia y Shen Tar de Corea.
The referees for these games are Johan Freiberg from Sweden and Shen Tok from Korea.
Le recordamos al público presente que el piso superior tiene capacidad limitada y en caso de abandonar el mismo solo podrá volver a ingresar sujeto a la capacidad del mismo. Recuerden que en los extremos de la cancha y en la planta baja contamos con espacio extra para que puedan disfrutar de esta competencia tan, pero tan emocionante. También le pedimos que cuiden sus pertenencias. A continuación, le pedimos al público presente que se pongan de pie, porque ya está todo listo y preparado. En instantes escucharemos los himnos nacionales de las diferentes selecciones.
Please rise for the anthems.
Escuchamos el himno nacional de China, Taipei.
Now we start with the anthem of Chinese Taipei.
Cuántas emociones, cuántos lindos recuerdos vividos. Y a continuación, el himno de los Estados Unidos.
And now the anthems of the United States of America.
Qué linda fiesta, qué lindo espectáculo seguramente van a brindar, porque las dos selecciones, China Taipei viene de ganar en todo el torneo 6 partidos, que se va a enfrentar a Estados Unidos, que ganó 3 y llegó acá a la final, esta final tan luchada entre varios países. Y de esta manera está por darse inicio, ahí se saludan, que suenen el aplauso que baje de las tribunas para estas selecciones. Ahora sí, después de 7 días de intenso torneo, de intensa competencia, está listo para dar cierre a esta categoría junior masculina del hockey en línea de estos World Sky Games Argentina 2022. Que lo viviste y lo disfrutaste desde el Parque Olímpico de la Ciudad Autónoma de Buenos Aires para todo el mundo. En instantes veremos quién simplemente ocupa el primero y segundo lugar, porque ellos ya ganaron, ya llegaron hasta acá, ya disfrutaron de esto, se divirtieron, hubo momentos de tristezas, de alegría, pero lo más importante es que puedas seguir disfrutando de esto, que es el hockey en línea.
Welcome to Buenos Aires, Argentina. This is the gold medal game of the junior men's division at the 2022 World Skate Games. I'm Alex Morrison here with Dave Hammond. We'll be bringing you the action this afternoon as Chinese Taipei faces the United States.
It's been a Cinderella story here for Chinese Taipei. They've walked through the entire competition thus far. The only undefeated team here in junior men's. The Americans, tougher route in round robin, came in as the fourth seed, upset kind of everyone here, and have walked through, found themselves in a gold medal match. No one can forget the semifinal match between Chinese Taipei and the Czechs. 10-1 for Taipei. Let's see if the Americans can slow down Chinese Taipei.
All ready for the opening faceoff, and there it is. Won by the U.S. Chinese Taipei with a lot of speed, and the U.S. will look to counter here with possession, and they keep that possession behind their own net.
The interesting thing thus far is Taipei plays with an extremely short bench. They've had some of their players have never even line changed during games. They've been doing this for a week straight. The big question will be, do they have enough left in the tank to take on the Americans who are rolling three lines?
That is an incredible thing to see when you have kids at this level, at this amount of intensity, not go off for a change. Well, the U.S. is sitting back here waiting to see what openings Chinese Taipei give. It is a little tough here as the U.S. with their red, white, and blue, and the Chinese Taipei's red, white, and blue. On those long stretch passes, things could get a little hairy. So we'll see how that goes as the game progresses, especially as the U.S. have their jerseys with those white stripe on the left arm.
You'll notice, Alex, here, I mean, you just got here, you know, in from the States. Taipei sits back in the box. They do not change their system. Doesn't matter what you do, they'll sit and wait. And as soon as you get down in their zone, you will watch the flurry.
Well, and here we go. It is Petro Monaco with a quick move, and he's able to beat a Chinese Taipei player with a little dangle. And now here is a little bit of aggressive behavior by Taipei as they come in and forecheck. Change that box up as possession wasn't completely controlled, but now the U.S. does control it. They're willing to push the puck up, and here's a loose puck. Just rolls off the stick of the U.S. player. Looks like that was Pietro Monaco. And the U.S. regains possession, and they send it all the way back to their D zone where they will set it up. No line changes yet. We're a minute 45 into this one. This is the gold medal game at the World Skate Games here in Buenos Aires, Argentina.
And, you know, the other big noticeable thing is all the Taipei players are playing with the three-wheel skate, something you don't see very often, but every single one of them is wearing the three-wheel skate. And I've got a little funny intuition tells me, depending on the results of this match, we might see the three-wheel skate getting a little bit more popular as they've been absolutely so agile and so fast. I cannot wait for you to see that the big three on Taipei get going here, 29, 97, and 18. No one has been able to stop them. Let's see if the Americans can find a way and slow this big three down.
So, Dave, I am looking here at those three wheels. Are they 80s?
They almost look like hundreds. They're definitely big wheels. They're bigger than an 80 for sure.
A little aggressive play there by Kuo from Chinese Taipei. They are able to almost get the turnover, but the U.S. is able to regain possession. And here comes Taipei. It's a quick little turnaround. Two on one. They lose the handle. That was Wu, 29. And the U.S. regain possession of the puck. Little dangle attempted there by Taylor. And there's a puck swatted at by Phillips, the strong player from the U.S.
Yeah, 87, Sam Phillips. He's been their leading goal scorer thus far in the tournament. Huge match he had in the semis. And let's see if he can continue the momentum, get on the board early.
Well, Chinese Taipei not afraid to be physical with Sammy Phillips, taking him into the boards there. We'll see if that continues as the game progresses. U.S. win the faceoff. Here's Fisher with the puck. He sends it back into the zone. U.S. will control it. Stretching the floor, they have one player in front of the net, another player all the way down behind the goal, and a player circling out at center floor. They cross center floor. Shot goes wide, and the U.S. still have possession. Send it back into their zone. This is a very typical Anthony Violante coach team. Really like to slow the game down, look for mistakes, and capitalize on them.
Yeah, he's got a very good program out there in New York with the Roadrunners. I mean, they've really made strides and become one of the top pro teams almost in America now.
Well, these are the future pros, and here they come. On the forehand, a little wraparound attempt there by the U.S., steered aside by the Chinese Taipei goaltender. That looked like Phillips there with the attempt. And now Fisher with the forecheck. This is Yang with the puck behind the Chinese Taipei net. Yang sends it over to Kuo.
Quo this, with puck?
This boy with a puck has been absolutely memorizing. It's like a magnet on there. He's been the talk of the tournament.
Well, Quo makes one move around Stanbros, feeds it over to Tung. Tung with the puck in the corner. Makes a little move and tries to center it. Goes off the goalie stick, and he's able to regain possession. It's Tung with the puck, and he sends it back into his D zone. Lai sends it across the line, back over to Tung. Here's a little move. Quo with that shot steered aside, and the U.S. will gain possession in the corner. A little aggressive by Chinese Taipei. Let's see if U.S. tries to break out quickly. No, instead they do just gain possession of the puck and will be satisfied to go behind their own net while they have players changing.
And for the first time here in Buenos Aires, we have a sellout crowd. There's actually a line outside trying to get into the venue as we speak. Not a seat left in the building. So unbelievable atmosphere for the boys to be playing in the gold medal match. Chinese Taipei versus the USA.
All right, centering attempt does sail wide of the U.S. stick, but here they come. It's Fisher with the puck. He feeds it back. Shot goes wide by Stanbrough. Now here's Boyle with the puck. Boyle on his forehand sends it around the net and back into his D zone where the U.S. will regain possession. You can see the players going for a change.
Boyle had that big goal against Namibia there right at half that really got his team back in the game. They were down 3-0 at halftime in the semis to Namibia. And Boyle put the team on his back, got the goal, and they scored four in the last 4 minutes.
Here come the U.S. with Boyle shooting right into the chest of the Chinese Taipei goaltender. A lot of people that were watching that Namibia-U.S. game in the semis had decided they may turn it off. It looked like Namibia was going to run away with it. But the U.S. with an incredible comeback and making it to this gold medal game. Little win off the faceoff. Looks like that was Wolcott that was able to sneak in behind the defensive player. We do get a whistle and another faceoff as Boyle will try and win this. Looks like on his forehand. And go, no, he wins it on his backhand. Sends it back out to the point. Here's Pietramonico. Puck knocked off a stick, but a quick turnover. Here's the U.S. coming back in. Little move. Just kind of falls off the stick. And the puck is sauced out, but it bounces over the U.S. stick, and here comes that dangerous Quo. Centers the puck, and it goes just out of the reach of his teammate. Here's Quo with the puck again. Shot sails wide. Yang digs the puck out of the corner. Pressured by the U.S., Taipei sends the puck back in their D zone, where Lai sends it to the far side of the rink. It's Wu with the puck. Here's Wu coming down center. A little hook-ish. Stick caught in the hands, but the referees decide to let it go. And here come Taipei, try to make a move through three U.S. players. That doesn't work. It's a 3-on-2 if they hurry. Now it's 3-on-3 for the U.S. Wide angle shot, and a goal by the USA as Boyle makes an incredible pass across the rink.
And that is the first time in this tournament Taipei has fallen behind in a game. Let's see how they respond. USA up 1-0 here in the gold medal. Incredible pass there by Boyle. Finds his line mate backdoor. Big, big goal.
That was great puck movement. Got the goalie moving side to side. It was Wolcott with the goal on the one-timer. And the U.S. Carson Wolcott puts them up 1-0. 13:04 to go in the first half of play. U.S. win the faceoff and regain possession. And here we go with that puck possession game. They'll set it up, stretching the floor. They have one player all the way down behind the opposing net. And here they come as Taipei does try to pressure. They take advantage of it. A little spinorama move there by Stanbrough. Loses the handle quickly, but then regains it. Now back to Taipei as they throw the puck away to the U.S. All the way down the other end of the floor, it's the U.S. Pretty aggressive by Taipei.
Yeah, the Taipei will almost be forced to get out of their box. They're definitely going to have to now chase the puck. They've always been accustomed to playing with the lead, so sitting back in a box works in that scenario. But now, whole new game here. 12 minutes remaining here in the first period. USA out in front, 1-0 over Taipei.
Well, U.S. moving the puck side to side here. A little move at center, and a shot sails high by the U.S. They are able to keep the puck. Centering pass off of the goaltender and goes in. A fortunate bounce for the United States as they just throw the puck out front. A bad luck goal against for Chinese Taipei as the U.S. go up 2-0.
The stars are lining up for USA, that is for sure. Taipei looks confused. They've called a timeout, it looks here. They're going to settle things down. This is the first time they have ever felt some adversity in this tournament.
Well, Taipei smartly slowing things down. They want to get back into their game that got them to this point. This is the undefeated Chinese Taipei team that really walked through the tournament, handling every team they faced pretty well. That first game they did play against the United States was on day one, if I recall correctly. And they handled the U.S. pretty handily.
Yeah, I mean, they've gone through everyone. They beat the Italians 8-2, the Czechs 10-1. I mean, it's been a wrecking crew. Everyone coming to this game, they thought it was going to be a landslide. And, you know, it's a gold medal game. Anything can happen. 2-0 in the first 18 minutes of play here. And it's been all USA.
Well, you saw that spinorama move there by Stanbro. And Kuo, the best player, in my opinion, from Chinese Taipei, really aggressive, knocking the puck off his stick. And it seemed like the defense did their job. And just a fortunate bounce for the U.S. goes in the net, and off they go. It's 11:58 to go here. U.S. is up 2-0 in the gold medal game here at the World Skate Games.
Looks like to be some Taipei fans have woken up. Not sure where they found them, but there's a loud chant going for them.
It looks like it's the Chinese Taipei folks that have come in for the second half of this tournament. They arrived this morning. Actually, we're on my flight through Dallas-Fort Worth. And they are here with numbers and loud and wanting their team back in this game. 11:18 to go, U.S. with possession of the puck. So Taipei out of the box into a pretty aggressive forecheck. And the U.S. able to maintain possession. They are moving the puck pretty well when they do have pressure. You see Tung from Chinese Taipei pressuring the U.S., but here's a little give and go as the U.S. move it out to center. Here's a shot off the goalie. Rebound is knocked out to center. U.S. throwing another puck, another shot, and a save and held on to by Chinese Taipei. That's Sue in goal, 10:41 to go in the first half.
It is all USA in the first 10 minutes to go here. Complete domination of the puck, all the momentum, and they're getting lots and lots of scoring chances here. Taipei needs to wake up.
Well, they get a faceoff win here, hoping to maintain possession there. They do not. Puck knocked off of Phillip's stick, though. Here comes Taipei. Little play, back door, and there's a goal.
29-18. We've seen those numbers link up probably about 40 times already in the tournament, and here he comes.
That's Kuo, number 18 from Wu, 29, and Chinese Taipei cuts that deficit in half. It's 2-1 with 10:28 to go in the first half. It looks like it went off the left skate of Kuo, but it was not directed in by any sort of kicking motion. So that is a good goal. And it's U.S. 2, Chinese Taipei 1 now. A lot of game to go. Here comes the centering pass picked off by the U.S. Looks like a 2-on-1 if they hurry. 3-on-1, there's a pass out to Phillips. Puck knocked off his stick, one pass too many. And Chinese Taipei able to thwart that 3-on-1 chance.
Keep an eye on the Taipei lineup here. You got 3, 18, 29, and 97. Just take a notice here how long they take their shifts.
Well, there is 18 sending over to 14. He loses the handle briefly. U.S. able to knock the puck off his stick briefly, and now they have the puck. It's Sammy Phillips with it. Pulls the puck around the net. Able to send it up, and there's a bad turnover. Miscommunication by the U.S. Here comes Kuo with a puck and a shot. Steered aside by the U.S. goaltender. Chinese Taipei fans going nuts at every single thing that the Chinese Taipei does. U.S. coming back the other way. Playing with the puck on the perimeter. That was so Soboslay.
Great puck possession here by the Americans. Controlling things down. They're playing their game, forcing Taipei to get out of their little structure there.
I'm not sure if you're losing this on your end. Our monitor goes out every once in a while. But here comes Boyle with the puck. Boyle goes to his backhand, has the puck knock off his stick. It's 2-on-1 for Taipei. Oh, here's a breakaway. And a shot sails wide by Wu from Chinese Taipei. Turnover to the U.S.
Not much hustle there by 2-9. Maybe a little tired. Another little breakaway. Side break, makes his move. Nice save there by the American keeper to keep things at bay.
Yang goes to the backhand, tries to go 5-hole. And we'll see this on the replay as he's sprung free right there, backhand. A little defensive slash there by the U.S. But the puck doesn't go in, and Lyon with a big save. Puck to the right, or faceoff to the right of goaltender Lyon. And Chinese Taipei wins the faceoff, sends it back into their D zone where Kuo will handle it. A little bit more pressure, some stick work here by the U.S. Referees apt to let them play. Another little stick there. Tongue with the puck. And it's sent aside, and the U.S. regained possession. Dangerous pass there in the D zone, but the U.S. fortunate to recover. Here's Wolcott with the puck across center ice. Center floor, here he comes. He makes the dish, gets taken down. No call, referee in the way there, and it's turnover. Chinese Taipei regains possession. 7:57 to go in the first half of play. Taipei on the far side sends it over to Yang. Yang throws it to the net. Backhand attempt sails up and over. That was by Kuo. I don't believe Kuo's gotten off the rink yet, has he?
No, he has not. And he's always he's a pass first, shoot second. But surprisingly, he's leading the tournament goals as well. So he's just there setting guys up.
There is a weak attempt as Pietro Monaco sends it across the rink, and it's thrown toward the net. And Chinese Taipei get the quick little break. 7:31 to go here in the first half of play.
You know, with the style of play of the Taipei, it's really hard to decide who's a forward, who's a D. I mean, the guys just stay out there, but their defense back in is so offensive that they're almost like four forwards out there.
Here's Chien taking the faceoff for Taipei. U.S. is able to win it. Pietro Monaco handles the puck and skates back toward his own net. Surveys the floor. Now the U.S. collapses. Ball back. Four players in their D zone. No one stretching.
Look at the crowd, the peanut gallery behind the Americans here. I mean, there's spectators just crawling in everywhere. Not a seat available in front of us. And look at the behind the nets. There is not an open space in the entire building right now.
This is most certainly a standing room only crowd here for this junior men gold medal game to the 2022 World Skate Games here in Buenos Aires, Argentina at the Olympic Park. And there's a turnover. U.S. puck knocked off their stick. They send it back. 3-on-2. Great defensive play there by Fisher getting back. Sent over. It's Kuo. Dangerous Kuo with the puck. He makes a move. Puck knocked off his stick. Kind of a weak wrister there thrown. And it's a turnover. 2-on-1 for the U.S. 2-on-1. It's shot right into the chest of the Taipei goalie. A little back and forth. Oh, back and forth action as a U.S. player goes head first in the boards. Looked like he may have tripped over himself there. Looks like he's popped back up, and off we go. That was Stanbro that went down. Here come the U.S. back. Puck knocked off their stick, and here come Chinese Taipei. 3-on-2 if they hurry. Stood up. Great, great defensive play there by the U.S. So it's a weak shot on goal and a faceoff.
Great game thus far. You can see the Americans really playing the body there on 18, really trying to take him out of the game, making him physically go through them.
Well, the crowd's getting boisterous now. Quite loud in here, 6:04 to go in the first half. Faceoff won by the U.S. And here comes that stretch again as the U.S. sent a player all the way down the other end, trying to spread out the Chinese Taipei defense. And they do exactly that. Get a shot, just sails up and over the net. Chinese Taipei go the other way, and they are apt to just kind of slow it down here. Taipei wanting to keep possession, now setting a play up. They're playing a little bit of the stretch game as well, sending multiple players down and weaving back and forth, kind of like darting in and out. Oh, there's the puck knocked off the stick of Kuo. It's a 2-on-2 for the U.S. A shot steered aside by the blocker of Su, the Chinese Taipei goaltender.
5 minutes remaining here in the first half. USA with the puck down on their own end. Taking their time, making sure it's a puck possession game for the Americans. They've got the lead. The clock is in their advantage.
And Dave, what's your feeling on this game plan here by the U.S. with Chinese Taipei wanting to keep the same players on the floor for minutes on end? It's allowing them a little bit of a rest here, right?
Yeah, I mean, in a situation like that, you want to keep the puck. Keep the puck as long as you can, because you've got another team that's not changing, and they can't score any if you have the puck. So there's no need to force anything like this. I mean, there's no need to take it in. Taipei's just sitting back and waiting for those odd man breaks. And if I'm the Americans, I stand behind my net for as long as possible. If they force, I find the open guy and I go on the attack.
Well, here we go. And that's exactly what happened as Kuo forced the issue back behind the net. U.S. 3-on-3. Little move to the forehand. Puck in the corner. U.S. still with his... Oh, there's a turnover there. A little stick. And it's a turnover back to the U.S. Move to the front. Few little whacks here back and forth, but referees letting it go, which I think we all appreciate. Let the boys play here. And Yang now sends the puck back into his D zone. Yang does not connect on that pass. And there's another turnover for the U.S. 3:45 to go here in the first half of play.
Taipei looks tired.
It's a 3-on-3 for the U.S. centered. And that puck just rings off of the pipe. Goes up in the air. And Chinese Taipei may come the other way. U.S. with four players back in their D zone, not allowing any odd man opportunities for Chinese Taipei. They got burned a couple of times on those little mini breakaways, and I think they've changed their mentality here going forward. Puck sent behind the net. Here come the U.S. far side. Player working through the stick checks of the Chinese Taipei player. Puck sent back into the D zone of the U.S.
A lot of energy being wasted here by Taipei as they don't have the puck. They're getting caught in battles along the wall, physically demanding stuff, and it's just wearing them down. Taipei looks tired.
Well, here comes Boyle with the puck on his forehand. Wrister sails wide of the net, and that's a turnover. Chinese Taipei 1-on-2. No help here. Not a lot of gas here in the Chinese Taipei legs. There is a shot attempt. Sails off the stick of Wu, number 29. Wu still with the puck. On the near side, Wu goes to his backhand. Puck knocked off. Pietromonaco with the D. Puck sent back into the D zone. This is Tung, who slows it down. Sends it to Wu. Wu cuts back to the middle, loses the puck. And here come the U.S. So Boyle just has the puck roll off his stick, and now all of a sudden it's a 4-on-2 for Chinese Taipei. Kuo tries to make a move through two players, and the puck just sails off his stick. 1:50 to go here in the first half. Here they come again. Oh my goodness, this could be a penalty shot as he had a breakaway. Let's see what the referee does here. Looks like he's just going to give a penalty. First penalty of the game here as Kuo makes that happen with his speed.
He's a one-man highlight reel, and he's putting the team on his back, trying to get them back into it. Looks like some of his brothers there are a little bit tired, and he's finding a way to go. Every shift, he's dangerous out there.
So, yeah, you can see right there the hook by Pietromonaco right into the belly of Kuo, and Chinese Taipei will have their first power play opportunity of the game. 1:42 to go here in this first half. U.S. with a big faceoff win here, and they just send the puck down to center floor. Chinese Taipei with the puck. It's Wu. Sends it over to Kuo. Sends it over to the far side. Back to Kuo. Over to Wu. To Kuo. Back to Wu. There's a shot. They're looking for a backdoor play. That shot goes wide. I think it was more of a pass.
Minute 15 remaining in the first period.
And Kuo with the puck. Little weave here.
Oh, nice play.
And that's Tung with the puck. Puck blocked in front. Wu with it. Wu back to Kuo. Kuo over to Tung. They're going to switch spots here. So Tung gets over to the right side on, as a lefty shot. And he sends it right into the chest of the U.S. goaltender. No eye is taken away. No change of direction. That's going to be an easy save most of the time for that U.S. goaltender. Right, Dave?
Absolutely. You know, they've run their play the whole time, but it's against a different team. This is not the same American team they found in round robin. It's a complete newly identified team. And Taipei needs to adjust their strategy as well, you know?
Well, in talking to Dan Maxwell, USA coach, they are a put-together team from players from around the country that do not practice. There's a big shot steered aside by the U.S. goaltender. It seems like their practice may have come in their first few games, and now they're putting things together here. Taipei sends it back up top. It's Kuo. Sends it over to the near side. It's Wu now with the puck. 27 seconds to go in the period. 42 in the power play. There's another one, and Wu just doesn't get the shot off that he was looking for. Faceoff will be to the left of Lyon.
Nothing too spectacular here on the power play. They're just staying out in their lanes and just moving the puck. I mean, USA obviously knows what they're trying to do with the big three up top there. I think the play here is download a three. He's maybe a little bit left open.
Well, here's three on that forecheck, getting that puck back for Chinese Taipei after the faceoff loss. 12 seconds to go here in the first half. They're going to try and create something, and here it is. Wu! The puck just kind of sails off a stick. 5 seconds to go. Wu again. Great defensive play by the U.S., sacrificing his body.
They're almost too patient there. I mean, there was two opportunities for the one-timer, and they almost get too cute, and they make the pass back when, you know, I think he could have probably shot the very first one, but then again, we're not sure what they see out there. We're standing here looking at a monitor.
Absolutely. So that was Sabaslay sacrificing his body, taking that block. 2 seconds to go. 1 second, and that is halftime. It is United States 2, Chinese Taipei 1 at the end of one half a play.
You got to think, if you're USA right now, you are tickled to death. You are feeling good about yourselves to be leading 1-0 against the almighty Taipei going into the final 20 minutes for a gold medal. You can't be happier. Taipei, on the other hand, they need to find some energy. They've got to get back to playing their game. Right now, they're playing USA's hockey game, and USA's playing it better.
Well, Chinese Taipei now getting a much-needed break for those big three, as they were on the floor the entire first half of play, 20 straight minutes for number 18 for sure. And I don't know that I saw 29 come off the floor.
Yeah, I saw 97 take a shift, but 29 and 3 might have been there the whole time too. Hasn't been too many numbers for Taipei out in the rink. It just is what it is. And, you know, they know. Leave everything on the rink, 20 minutes to go, but you got to think their bodies are wearing down. You see the tape coming off the guys' bodies. You can see it's on the neck, it's on the wrist. There's definitely some sore muscles there, but let's see if they can figure a way.
This is not a short tournament, as play began on Tuesday, and today is Sunday, and they have been going in long games. These are not little roller hockey tournament games that are 40 minutes. These are hour and a half, grind them out games. And their bodies are starting to show a little bit of wear, just like you're talking about. And so this five-minute break could come in huge for this Taipei team. Let's see how they come out in the second half.
Yeah, obviously, we've got to keep in mind each team has a timeout. So, you know, that's something the Taipei coach will have to monitor. Perhaps, depending on what the scores, you take it a little bit early, maybe around the 10-minute mark. And, you know, hope your opponents also have to take a timeout later on in the game. It's almost two extra breaks there. A little bit of strategy. But we'll just have to see how this plays out. If the Americans can keep the lead, they can dictate the clock, which dictates the play. Keeps them in charge.
Well, that first game back on October 25th, it was the 8 a.m. game, Chinese Taipei. It was the second game for each team in the tournament. They won 5-3, and it seemed like, if you can recall back to that, Dave, it seemed like they dominated that game.
Yeah, I mean, the score actually is, it's one of the closer games that Taipei played in it. But I mean, if you look what they did to the rest of the competition once they got going, it was something special. I mean, they've got three guys leading the entire tournament, 1, 2, and 3. It's just been a stat weekend for these guys. And, you know, they've made everything look easy. It's been seamless. You never know really who to cover. You know, you got 18 out there dictating the play and setting the tempo. But there's just so many arsenals. I almost think it's Tom Brady out there throwing to his wide receivers. It's just, it's been brilliant to watch.
Well, in all of your experience, Dave, have you has there been an Asian team from anywhere on the Asian continent that's looked this dominant during the tournament? Obviously, this game is a little different story, being down 2-1. Have we had this?
Yeah, I don't even think we've ever had an Asian team make the semis. This is something huge. I believe back in Nanjing, the junior women's got to the bronze medal game. But other than that, in the men's or boys' divisions, they've never gotten this far. Don't even know if they've ever made it to the top eight. So this is something very, very special.
Well, we'll take a two-minute break here while you watch the highlights here from the first half of play. It's U.S. 2, Chinese Taipei 1. We are back with you here in Buenos Aires, Argentina. We'd like to thank those of you joining us watching on the Olympic Channel, as well as streaming on worldskategames.tv. It's United States 2, Chinese Taipei 1 in this junior men's gold medal game.
Taipei still on the power play here. They've got 17 seconds remaining.
Well, the U.S. win that faceoff. 14 seconds to go. Bad bounce here. Chinese Taipei able to regain possession. They have 5 seconds and one more chance at a shot on goal before this penalty expires. And here they go. Great block by the U.S. U.S. doing a good job sacrificing bodies in front. Here comes the U.S. It's Fisher with it. Tries to make a move around the Taipei player. And that's a turnover. And it's Kuo. Look at him move. Kuo tries to make a centering pass. U.S. thwart that attempt, and here they come the other way. A little hook there that Wu gets away with from Chinese Taipei. Referees say play on, and here we go. He walks back. Oh, my goodness. He tries to sneak one in short side, and the goaltender from Chinese Taipei, Zhu, is able to hold on with his glove arm.
I'd like to see Kuo almost try to shoot the puck a little bit more. Everyone knows he's a pass-first guy, and he needs to almost get selfish right now. He had the opportunity on the two-on-one. I like what Sam Phillips did here on the Americans. He looks his guy off, takes the shot, and almost gets the goalie sleeping.
Well, the U.S. win this faceoff. That seems to be a big key for them. They have won, I would guess, 75% of the faceoffs in this game, and that puck possession has been a huge advantage for them. So here's Phillips sending the puck across the rink and into the corner. The U.S. loses it. Here comes Chinese Taipei. Looks like a two-on-two with help for the U.S. Oh, my goodness, he gets a rebound, and it's a goal, a huge rebound out in front, and Wu is able to get his own rebound and stuff it home. We have a tie game.
You know, everyone there is so excited for the goal except for the man that scores it. You know, he just scores it, no hands up, nothing, just walks over. You know, it's probably his 15th of the tournament, but what an individual play here. And we've got a 2-2 game with 18:48 to go.
Well, Dave, the way you've been talking about these guys being on the floor the whole time, he was probably too tired to lift his arms. He's back out there, though, and they still haven't come off.
Yeah, you're not changing these guys. It's the gold medal game. Leave everything on the table.
All right, well, U.S. with possession of the puck. Let's see how they counter this Chinese Taipei goal to tie it up. U.S. was up 2-0 at one point. Chinese Taipei scored the last two. And the puck sent all the way down to the end of the rink. U.S. has possession with someone open in front. Little defensive breakdown there for Chinese Taipei, and they get away with it as the puck was never sent out in front.
Actually surprised how big Taipei is physically, known to be a very small nation. I mean, this goalie, definitely one of the bigger physically goalies in the tournament. You see when he's on his knees, he still heads way above the crossbar here.
Well, here's another faceoff by the U.S. It's one, a little move, a shot just sails wide. I believe that was Taylor with the puck. Here's Phillips, who tries to send it down. It goes off of a Chinese Taipei player. Little tongue twister there, and the U.S. come back out on the far side as they skate across and then send it back to the point. It's Phillips. Phillips been on the floor quite a bit here.
Absolutely. See, 29's finally gone off. He's gone for a change here. We got 69 on the rink, but obviously 18, 97, and 3 remain on. So looks like they're just trying to rotate one of their big guys every now and then, but we've yet to see 18 go anywhere near that bench.
Well, with six players on the bench for Chinese Taipei, I'm not sure if a few of them are just filling water bottles or breaking a sweat at all, but they're excited about this game being 2-2.
Yeah, a lot of support there. Got a lot of guys dressed, but you got to earn your rink time with that, coach. I can tell you that. Yeah,
absolutely. Well, the U.S. has the puck still, and they just are happy to skate back. Hold possession, and here's the box again by Chinese Taipei, forcing the U.S. to skate forward as they can't just hold it behind their net with no pressure. Here's a pass to the far side. Nice little move there by Phillips, and he loses the handle. Puck goes down behind the net, and Chinese Taipei now with the puck. They switch spots, let quarterback Kuo bring it up the floor. Almost like a point guard in basketball.
Absolutely. Look at him. You know the pass is coming.
And he sends it back, and it's a goal by Tong! As he sends it back to Tong, who's at the top of the circles and just rifles it past the goaltender Lion. It's Chinese Taipei 3, United States 2.
And the Americans have got to be aware of that. The same guys are on the same play all week. He's a pass-first guy. He draws everyone to him, throws it back to his big shooter, and there it is, 3-2 Taipei. And if USA is not careful, the wheels are going to fall off.
A little screen there by the U.S. player. Perhaps Lyon wasn't able to see that off of the stick, but it is what it is. It's 16 minutes and 30 seconds to go in this game. The winner gets the gold. The loser gets the silver.
Three unanswered goals for Taipei now. And here Kuo comes again. Another steal.
Pietro Monaco tries the toe drag. Is not successful. Kuo gets a little hook. No call. U.S. lucky to get away with that one. That could have easily been a penalty call. And there's a dangle attempt that's thwarted by the U.S. And here they come. Shot sails wide. U.S. with the puck. They send it back in their D zone. That's Taylor who sends it across. Oh, and there's a bad turnover by the U.S. Right to Kuo, and there's another one of those passes, and he sends it over. Shot by Lai, sailed wide. And the U.S. back with the puck. Kuo on the forecheck for Chinese Taipei. U.S. with numbers back are able to get away from that pressure. 15 minutes, 20 seconds to go. Chinese Taipei 3, U.S. 2. And the U.S. needs to find a mistake by Chinese Taipei to get this goal.
And the big boys have all showed up tonight. 29, 97, and 18, all with goals for Taipei. And Kuo with a goal and two assists. He's delivered here. The bigger the stage, the bigger the game.
It's been a pretty incredible week for him. Obviously, minutes on the floor, he's outnumbered anyone out there. So his numbers, he has a chance of getting better numbers, being on the floor more. But
absolutely,
he sure has produced. Here's the U.S.
And 87's been dangerous for the Americans, Phillips, but he has yet to find the sheet. That could be the difference maker. He's going to have to find a way to get the puck in the back of the net.
Well, here's Fisher circling back in his D zone with the puck. U.S. playing a little keep away, trying to find someone making a mistake on that Taipei side, and they haven't done so yet. They're playing this box. Pretty hard to penetrate. They need a clean cross-ring pass here.
Yeah, usually when you got a box formation, you want to run your offense almost into a diamond, the old rink hockey style, where you've got to get some movement, stretch a guy, and use the middle of the box. You cannot play box versus box. You just never get in.
U.S. player goes down behind the net. Both Chinese Taipei defenders leave the area and leave the U.S. player with it. And
Kuo steals it.
Turnover. It's Kuo again. Oh, and they knew the pass was coming there. But here's a bad turnover. And Kuo with it in close. What a defensive play. Tying up Kuo's stick to prevent a shot.
13:46 remaining here in the second period of the gold medal game, junior men.
Here's Wu with the puck. He crosses center floor, makes a move around a player, takes a shot, sails up and over and out of play. And that'll send the faceoff out to center floor.
It's a short breather, but much needed here for Taipei.
When Taipei's had the puck, it has been nonstop action. The U.S. doing everything they can to slow things down, possess the puck. And it's just too much. And here's Taipei with the puck again. There's a little mistake to prevent it, but here's the forecheck by Wu. And Taipei causing all sorts of problems. And the aggressive forecheck by Tung there. U.S. had numbers there, but here we go again with Kuo. Here's the feed. It's a shot. Sails wide. Tung with the puck down in the corner. Body there by the U.S. Good defensive play. And Phillips sends the puck up to Boyle. Boyle tries to stuff it in. Here's Phillips right into the breadbasket of Zhu, the Taipei goaltender. 12:52 to go in the second half. And we have a timeout on the floor. We'll see who called it here.
You got to think it's taken by Taipei.
And you are correct, sir. Chinese Taipei take a timeout. 12:52.
And that's sheer just to give the boys a breather. You can see here is 18 getting some much needed water. 97 doing the same. I mean, these guys, yeah, it's just giving these guys a breather. 13 minutes to go here. They're going to have to find a way. A lot of time left for the Americans. They must just be patient now. No need to force. The clock's in their favor. There's no need to hit the panic button. They must stick with their game plan, move the puck wide, cut to the middle, and get some traffic in front of that goalie.
So, Dave, you can see here on the screen, Kuo is actually wearing a glove under his gloves. Is that...
We are unsure if it's for hygienic reasons or maybe for more grip. He's been doing it all week. This guy is a trendsetter, and I wouldn't be surprised if more people start following him. I know for myself, I've got a pair of three-wheel skates. I might be pulling them out of the cupboard because this guy's been absolutely amazing.
Well, I have my V-forms. Maybe I can take one off of those and try and balance myself.
You know, we think we know the game better, but, I mean, you just watch the way he plays. It's so effortless, and he's there to make his teammates better. You know, it's always what can he do for his teammates, block the shot, do this. And, you know, the points are going in, but it's more on what he's doing without the puck. That's been impressive for me.
Well, you see Dan Maxwell there with the U.S. squad trying to put a play together here. They do have an attacking zone faceoff with 12:52 to go, and they don't want to wait to try and tie this up. I'm sure they want to get back on the board right now.
I mean, look at the lineup on the faceoff. Four Chinese pay all in a row here, no one back. It's just everything they're doing is against the book here, you know, and it seems to be working for them. So what do I know?
Well, Phillips does have the puck now, dangerous player for the U.S. He sends it back, and let's see what the U.S. tries to do here to set up some offense. One player stretching. Puck gets over to Phillips. He comes in with some speed. Puck knocked off his stick by Tung. Back in the U.S. possession. Body there by Lai in the corner. No call. And Taipei back with the puck. Looks like it's Kuo down here in this near side corner. And Taipei is now slowing the game down. Little change of pace here after this timeout in strategy. Let's see how the U.S. attacks this. And there it is behind the net waiting for a mistake. And there it is, U.S. puck. 12 minutes to go. We're here in Buenos Aires. It's the United States versus Chinese Taipei in the gold medal game of the junior men's division at the 2022 World Skate Games. This looks like Jagiello back behind the net. Drops it off for Boyle. And here comes Boyle using his own player as a pick. Boyle with a little move to his backhand loses the handle on the forehand, and here come Chinese Taipei Big shot there by Tong, sails wide. I don't know if he knew how much time and space he had. But here come the U.S. the other way. Phillips taking off the puck. And Taipei want to maintain possession. That's exactly what they do. A little give and go here. Tong sends it across, and they will cross. Oh, my goodness, and he shoots the other way and beats a goaltender glove side. That's a goal by Chinese Taipei's Tong.
97 from 18, and now we've got a two-goal lead, 11 minutes remaining, and for the first time, we see some emotion by Taipei, a little bit of celebration. Maybe they're starting to realize what they're about to do.
There was a little screen there by Chien, 69. Briefly, but no, I'm not sure. I think the goaltender just got flat beat. Maybe he got caught out of position, and it's 4-2. U.S. now needs to scramble to put this together if they want to make a game of it. 11 minutes to go. Chinese Taipei, four unanswered goals. Unbelievable. After going down 2-0, the U.S. looked like they were going to dominate, and this is sure is a different story right now, Dave.
Oh, yeah. And Taipei no longer looks tired. Look at them. I mean, they're coming. Nice glove save there by the keeper to give himself a chance. But these boys are hungry. What I picture these guys are like sharks. And right now, the water's been chummed, and they're coming.
And we have a timeout by the U.S. After that shot by Tong, he shot the same exact side he just scored the goal on, and the goalie was not about to allow that to happen. So smart timeout here by Dan Maxwell. 10:42 to go here in the second half.
The best part about the timeout is 18 finally gets a breather, but he doesn't even sit down. He just stands by the bench, gets a drink of water. You know, it's something. You know, maybe he's keeping the legs loose. You know, doesn't want to cramp up. You know, obviously the guys are very young, very, very fit. But it's just interesting tactics, and it seems to be paying off.
Well, it looks like from across the rink here, we're watching Dan Maxwell talk to his players. And it looks like he's talking to Clay Taylor about really trying to make sure that he's stretching the floor and spreading out. I think part of the mistake with that last play was that turnover, two players on the same side. You're bringing the defensive player over to your side, and it makes it easier for the defending team to create that turnover. So Maxwell gets another 1 second, and the timeout's now over. We will line up at center floor, 10:42 to go. Chinese Taipei 4 looking for the first gold medal in the history of any Asian country at the World Skate Games. And a correction here. The faceoff is going to be to the right of Lyon, the U.S. goaltender. The big three out for Chinese Taipei. U.S. win the faceoff. They're down the near side. Little bounce pass off the boards, goes too far. Kuo tries to make a spinorama move, loses the puck, but here come Taipei. 2-on-1. Little move to the outside, centering pass, goes nowhere, and the U.S. get it back. U.S. 2-on-1 if they hurry, but a good back check there by Tong, able to thwart the odd man rush. U.S. still with the puck, down in the near corner.
You got to love the urgency now by the Americans. You can see it, they've put it in a new gear. And they definitely look like they're coming.
Here's Fisher with the puck. Crosses the center line, drops it off. And the U.S. look to find a hole in the slot. They keep using the perimeter, getting away from pressure, stretching the floor now. Chinese Taipei not biting, though. They are not crossing that red line while the U.S. has full possession. You can actually see right there, Tong turning around and not crossing the line. Here's Fisher with the puck on his forehand. Takes a shot, blocked by Taipei. Loose puck in front. And the Chinese Taipei goaltender, Hsu, is able to cover the puck. 9:29 to go in the second half. Faceoff will be to the right of Taipei goaltender, Hsu. Phillips with the faceoff for the U.S. And they control it. Puck center back out just goes under Phillips' stick, but the U.S. able to control. They send it back into their D zone, and we'll set it up.
Looks like the Americans have also shortened their bench. Got the same guys coming out more regularly.
There's a little move. Unbelievable. Kuo again on his forehand, takes the shot, looks like it might have been going wide, but the U.S. goaltender Lyon able to glove it down and cover it up.
You know, I think what the crowd loves so much is he's making all these dangerous plays in his own end, and it gets everyone oohing and on. It's just amazing to see the confidence he has. Doesn't matter where he's on the rink, he banks himself, and he takes it.
Here's a faceoff win by Chinese Taipei. That was Chien. And there's a turnover. Here comes the U.S. 3-on-2 if they hurry. Rolling puck. Knocked off the stick, and that's Kuo playing at both ends of the rink, defensively, offensively. It's pretty incredible to watch this guy. Lai now with the puck in the corner and sends it back. U.S. with an aggressive forecheck. Here's a turnover. And Kuo is able to come out with it. Here's a penalty to the U.S. Looks like a little rough penalty for that trip. 8:37 to go, and Chinese Taipei up 4-2 will go on the power play.
Tough one here for the Americans. They've got to find a way to kill this. Perhaps even get one shorthanded. 8:37 to go. Tough spot to be in, but you know what? A little bit of adversity builds character.
Well, you see Kuo getting directions from the bench. Looks like they're really telling him to stay up top to prevent that shorthanded possibility. 8:34 to go. 2-minute penalty here to the U.S. for tripping. That was to Boyle. And Chinese Taipei have the puck back in their zone. Send it across to the far side. Here's the puck to Tung. Tung scored that fourth goal to increase the lead to 2. Here's a shot. Good eat by the U.S. defensive team. Back up top. Another pass by Kuo.
Look at the puck movement.
And that was Tung missing it on that great feed by Wu.
They move the goalie so well. If you look where the goalie is, they get him moving so much and have the easier shots.
Tung tries to go far side, misses the net to the left. Kuo with the puck again. Patient. Back to Tung, over to Wu.
Minute to go still here in the power play. Taipei in complete control.
And there's a shot steered aside by the U.S. goaltender. Sent back over to Wu. Wu to Kuo. Kuo to Wu. Wu goes far side to Tung. Back to Kuo with a shot. Goes up and over the net. Little loose puck in front. And the U.S. able to, for momentarily, have possession. But now Kuo using his body to protect the puck. 33 seconds to go. And they'll set it back up in this diamond. It's Tung with the puck. Back to Kuo. Back to Tung. Up to Kuo. Over to Wu.
Great puck movement.
There's a little behind the back pass to Wu. It takes a shot and it sails wide. Tung able to recover. U.S. now come the other way. Turnover. Little move there. And nothing going for the U.S.
Penalty.
We're back
over
to even strength. And that was Boyle coming out of the box, breaking up that play. And here we go. 3-on-2. And puck just rolls off the stick of the U.S. player. And here comes Chinese Taipei. It's Tung. Tries to feed it. Oh, my goodness. He was trying to hit Kuo off the defenseman's skate. And Lyon able to recover the puck in the crease. 6:19 to go in the second half of play.
Both teams have used their timeout, so time management here on your shifts, change with the puck, will be very, very important.
Well, here we go. 2-on-2 for the U.S. One little move, a great defensive play breaking it up. U.S. able to regain possession. They bring it back into their zone. And Fisher will control it. Fisher sends it over to Taylor. Taylor with a big shot. Misses high and left. And the puck rolls off the Chinese Taipei stick. U.S. have it back. Dangerous play. Skating in front of his own net was Fisher. Almost lost it.
Surprised, actually, how aggressive Taipei is right now on the forecheck. But, you know, they keep getting the puck, so...
Well, they do have the puck behind their own net. The U.S. are going to chase them out from behind. That was Stanbro chasing Taipei out from back behind. Now it's Lai with the puck. Lai tied up. He's able to spin around. And on the near side, here's Kuo. Kuo with the puck. A little move. And a weak little shot goes right into the goaltender, Lyon. He'll make the easy save, and the faceoff will be to Lyon's right with 5:17 to go. So there are those gloves we were talking about. It looks like they might be cloth gloves. I don't.
Maybe to prevent the sweat, keeps a little more grip on the stick. So I'm not really sure there, but there's always hygienic things at this time of season.
Well, whatever it is, it sure is working for this kid. It's pretty awesome to watch. Here's the U.S. A turnaround shot goes off the defenseman. Chinese Taipei with the puck. A little dangerous pass with a U.S. player sneaking behind him. It's 3-on-2 down low. And the Chinese Taipei goaltender, Hsu, is able to cover it. 4:52 to go in regulation.
Chinese goalie's also had one heck of a tournament. He almost gets overshadowed by the extreme amount of offense Taipei's brought. But you know what? He's been the backbone, and I think he gives his team confidence to try all this fancy stuff. You know, he's the only goalie here undefeated, and he's really been one of the outstanding players in this tournament so far.
Here's a little move by the U.S. A sauce pass doesn't quite connect. U.S. able to hold on to it. And yes, Pietro Monaco, a little spinorama move, sends it over to the far side.
Got some new players on for Taipei. Believe it or not, 18 has finally gone for a change. It's the first time he has gone off. Was not off very long, but he did go off.
All right, so 79 comes back on the floor. 4:34 to go. Faceoff to the left of Hsu, the Taipei goaltender. There's a big win by Chinese Taipei, and they'll control the puck and have the U.S. chase after him. Dangerous play there by Wu, but able to get away from the forecheck of Phillips from the U.S. Taipei happy to weave and bob and dodge and stay away from everything coming at him. Just over 4 minutes to go, and here come Chinese Taipei. Four players back for the U.S., and so Chinese Taipei just happy to turn around and throw the puck back. So it looks like they're going to start playing a little keep away as we cross that four-minute mark, and the crowd is going nuts. Tung with the puck. He loses it. Here's a scoring chance right now. It's a shot.
Unbelievable save.
Are you kidding me? As Hsu dives to his left, throws everything he can at the area of the empty net, and is able to get in the way of that puck. What a pass. Oh, my goodness. I'd love to see the behind-the-net shot here if they have it. The crowd is going nuts. Faceoff will be to the left of Hsu.
They are 3 minutes and 43 seconds away from the first gold medal in history for their country.
Player goes down for the U.S. off the face-off. This is Wu with the puck. Gets through two U.S. forecheckers. And now Tung with it. Tung. Little body. Crowd going nuts. Not too much going on there. Just a little acceptable physical play by Boyle. Shot goes wide there by Boyle as it's sent out in front. And the U.S. just sends it back out to center.
Taipei is clearly tired here. They're hanging on. Have they done enough? Have they given themselves the two-goal cushion? Can they hold off?
Here come the U.S. charging back the other way. Shot off the side of the net. Goalie stick is down behind the net. Let's see if that comes into play as Boyle brings it down low. Here's Boyle with a little move. Decides to hang on to it. Sauces it out to Barakar.
2:45 left.
U.S. with the puck on the far side. There's a shot. And a much-needed whistle for Chinese Taipei as Hsu was without a stick. And they were able to recompose themselves. While the U.S. are struggling to find an opening like they found for those first two goals early in the game. Stanbro wins the faceoff for the U.S. Puck sent out to center. 2:38 to go. Looks like they're trying to draw Kuo out and take him out of the play if they can, but there we go. Here's Kuo.
Unbelievable.
Goes down, pops back up, makes a little move to his backhand. Great save there by Lyon. Another centering pass to Ying. Ying sails it over the net. Scoring attempt after scoring. Oh, my goodness, this is incredible what we're seeing here by Chinese Taipei.
He just, every time the puck finds him, he just, I don't know how he still has speed.
There's another shot steered aside by the Taipei goaltender, U.S. with the puck.
Look at him.
And here we go. It's a little foot race. And I don't know how that just happened. And a great passer by Kuo gets it to Lai, and Lai just loses it into the goaltender.
Minute 45. You've got to think Americans have got to win the puck, get the goalie out, give themselves a chance.
So we have Kuo with that replay right there, popping back up, one hand on a stick, loses a stick on the other side, gets it, the puck magically finds him. It's like he's the magnet, the puck's metal.
Yeah.
It's pretty incredible. 1:40 to go. Taipei with a puck. Cross rink pass from Ying to Wu, and Wu puts it home and probably puts this game away for Chinese Taipei.
And I think the emotion is just sitting for the Taipei coach. First time you've actually seen them extremely celebrate. They know history is being made right now, and they've started the party already. A minute 36 to go. Taipei knows the gold medal is coming home.
An incredible play there. They have scored most of their goals on these types of plays, and it is just domination here. After going down 2-0 to score 5 unanswered goals, we have a minute 30 to go before Chinese Taipei wins their first ever gold medal. Here's the U.S. struggling to find something. They want to get back into this and give themselves a chance. There's a minute 18 to go. They need a goal now. And here's a shot, and it goes wide. Sorry, that shot was on goal and it bounced wide after it went off the goaltender. And here comes the forecheck of the U.S. They have pulled their goaltender. We have a player down in the far corner. There's a little dangle, stick in the hands. Is that Kuo again?
Yes, it is.
Unbelievable. So Taipei playing keep away now with the U.S.
There he is.
And
dancing.
He makes the move. He's probably going to pass it. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my God.
I have no words. If there is not a player of the tournament that's obvious, I've never seen anything like this.
Yeah. 6-2 game. I think he finished with all 6 points here. I mean, just doing everything. Look at him. Takes his time. No stress.
This is one of the most dominant individual performances as a teammate. It's incredible because he does use his teammates. He gets the puck around, and the puck magically finds him.
Yeah.
How does this happen?
I can tell you, we've taken notice. We've got a program with players from all over the world, and there's a couple of Taipei guys that are going to be getting letters from us. That's for sure.
Well, there's a goal, a quick one, 32 seconds to go, by Taylor on that turnover. I mean, yeah. We'll see.
32 seconds to go. You could see.
Although looking at the body language of Lion, I think
Taipei goalie not even paying attention anymore. He's kind of just, you know, they're already in celebration mode. They know they've done the job.
Well, a nice play there by Lion to put one home. Little pride goal, if nothing else.
Yeah.
And the U.S. are not willing to let this go. 24 seconds. They want another shot. There's a save by Hsu. 22 seconds. 6-3, Chinese Taipei.
They opt to leave the goalie in. Looks like the white flag has been waved.
And we are 22 seconds away from this place erupting.
Hopefully there's nothing silly at the end here and I'm going to get a clean finish.
One little push here, and they let it go, and there's a shot.
What a save.
Great save by Sue. 5 seconds to go. And the place is counting it down, and that's it. The gloves fly off. Everyone leaves the bench. It's a celebration as Chinese Taipei wins the first gold medal in the history of Asia's continent at the World Skate Games in 2022.
And this is what's so wonderful about the sport. The competition is played all over the world here. You don't know who the favorites are. Nobody would have picked these guys to go all the way. A true Cinderella story. They go undefeated, and nobody gets within 2 to 3 goals against them. Chinese Taipei is here to stay, and I can't wait to see these guys play seniors next week because the big three, Alex, guess what? They're staying. They're rostered. They're in the senior division, which starts tomorrow.
Wow. What? What a crazy, crazy finish here as Chinese Taipei is able to walk away with this gold medal, posing for their fans. It's 6-3. We will have the handshake here at the end. And the U.S. has to tip their hats
they
to
must.
Chinese
Taipei. And they should be proud. USA got off to a rough start in the tournament. Came in as the fourth seed, went through France, went through Namibia, found themselves all the way here, and come home with a silver medal. Nothing to be snobby about. They take a silver medal. But you know what? This year, it was all Taipei. Nothing you can do.
Well, congratulations to Chinese Taipei. We will have the medal ceremony out on the rink in a few moments.
After the senior.
And it'll be, after the senior women, it'll be the medal ceremony for both divisions, both the junior men and senior women's. So that's what's coming up next. It's a senior women's match, France versus Spain for the world championship. Thank you so much for joining us, Dave Hammond and Alex Morrison, saying good night from Buenos Aires, Argentina.
Thank you.